Okay, guys, so basically just... What'd she say?
What?
You're fucking in.
I'm in there, baby. If you got this, this is live right now. I'm about to get a smash sesh. Oh.
Blur. So guys, hope you guys enjoyed that little skit for the beginning of the video. It was pretty spontaneous. And so basically, yeah, I'm back to videos, but it's been like 2.5 months and it's time to get back to videos. So basically, I've been doing a lot recently. I'm gonna catch you guys up on that. But first, I don't know if you guys can see, I have a freaking pedo stash and I have freaking facial hair. So I gotta shave that up, do my hair, and then Blake is gonna come back and we're hitting some chest at the gym. So let's go. So from pedo man to normal man. So here we go. Got the hair done, clean shave. And I think it's time to work out now. Let's go. So basically what we're doing right now is 3 sets of 5 at 65% of our max for bench. And we're doing pause bends actually. What me and Blake and Bryce and just all my friends here at the gym have been doing is we've actually been running a program that me and Blake created. Right now we are on the third week of the third cycle of training. So we've been almost doing this program for 3 months now. And it's actually releasing to the public on September 15th. So let's go.
Yep.
Warm up sesh, my
press,
my chest is hella sore from last session.
Do it again.
I'm gonna go like max power lifter form today.
Arch that back, sir. Get that arch. Be that Instagram hoe. Just let it come out of you. Yes, mate.
Contracting harder than my mother
when she was giving me her birth.
So basically right now we got Blake doing what I was doing actually. What happened is he thought it was 3 sets of 8, man. So he was doing his percentage for 8. So this man's progressing, my dude, progressing.
So I was doing more weight than I should have been doing. So Ryan feels like he needs to do the same.
I gotta do it, man. I also gotta run the clock. So basically what we're gonna do is, I felt pretty good obviously on that last set. Last time we actually did 365 pause bench, I was actually working with 225 and we're doing about 73% of my lower rep max instead of 65. Go for it.
Easy. I forgot to count. I'm sorry.
Obviously, as you guys saw, you guys are gonna criticize me. That wasn't really a pause bench, so we gotta have a longer pause at the bottom. And yeah, let's go for it.
Easy, my.
So finish up that easy 3x5 work and now we are on the flat dumbbell press. And basically what we're doing is what we did about 2 days ago, because we did a little chest hypertrophy 2 days ago. And so we're gonna work up to like 60 or 70 pounds of dumbbells and then drop 10 pounds each and then see how far we get down. The pump is like crazy, like my chest is still a little bit sore from doing it about 2 days ago. So we're gonna see what happens today.
Man, I just wanna go flat.
He's bulked, but he's going shirtless, people.
Hope life!
Boy!
Okay guys, as you guys saw, Blake just did his set, and now we're getting into my set. I haven't had solid food in like 8 hours, or 9 hours now. It's like 1 in the morning. I've had a lot of chocolate milk though for the past 2 hours, so maybe the pump will keep on, but.
Let's see the pump!
The pump, alright.
David and Dylan in the thumbnail, and you're like, why they like aren't even in the video. And what I wanted to talk about was, for the past 4 years, I've been so close-minded on what I do for training. So basically for the first 4 years, I was literally only doing hypertrophy movements. I wasn't doing the big three, I wasn't doing squat, bench, or deadlifts. Obviously, like, I'd explain like why, like in videos, people always ask why I don't bench, and I always say because I had a shoulder problem. That healed up pretty quickly, and I was just so close-minded on hypertrophy because that's what I was kind of like taught. And why I was taught that is because I had the shoulder problem back then, and then obviously I'm much more independent with my lifting. My dad, you know, obviously stopped teaching me stuff and I learned my own ways. So I was just extremely close-minded from what I learned back then. So then I went to New Jersey in April, and obviously they were doing powerlifting style training. They were on the programs, power building, whatever you want to call it, whatever they're doing. And I was like, shit, well obviously since I'm with them, I gotta train like them, or else I'm obviously gonna be left out because everyone there is doing bench, squat, deads. And so I was like, damn, maybe I'll finally try it. And so I went for my bench max and I went for my squat max, and it like totally changed everything, because when I hit those, it felt amazing. It felt awesome. And I got a lot of motivation from it. So I was like, damn, well maybe I should actually kind of start putting this in my own routine. So for the first month back in Washington, I was like, you know what, let me just play around with it. So I played around with it a little bit, and then me and my friend Blake were like, damn, let's just fucking create our own program. So that's what we did. You know, we worked out percentages and stuff, we learned a bunch of shit, and we created it, and we've been running it for the past 3 months, and training has never been better. Like, obviously it's like super entertaining, super motivating to train with your friends and just like hitting all these strong lifts and hitting all these percentages. And we've been going above and beyond our percentages. We've been gaining strength like exponentially fast. You guys are gonna see in Friday's video. I know this is gonna be posted on Wednesday. And so basically, yeah, we've been running that, been in a huge surplus, just totally committing to power building, I guess. And it's been really paying off, and it's just been really fun. So basically what I wanna tell you guys is, if you guys are extremely close-minded about stuff, I mean, obviously it could be in life, but I'm just gonna talk about lifting. I'm not gonna be that deep. But just like, you know, maybe switch up your training once in a while and become a little more open-minded, because there are a lot of people that actually like to switch up their training like every fucking 2 weeks, but then there are a lot of people that just don't change their training at all, and you need to. And it'll help you progress, because obviously I literally just threw in these new compound movements, and I'm getting bigger and stronger, and I've already been lifting for 4 years, and I'm already making exponential gains off of this strength training, which is really weird for someone that's been lifting for 4 years, because my growth should be slowing down, but it's only speeding up now. So yeah, more of the story, don't be so close-minded with stuff, and change up your training. David and Dylan,
They influenced my style of training. Now I changed it up. And I will see you guys later. The program that I actually talked about releases on Friday when the video comes out at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time on my website. And yeah, I don't know. You guys will see.